Welcome to my channel. I'm Jiajing Xu. Let's look at the problem 22 in chapter 15. Chapter 15 is about waves. In this one, you can see we have a wave function d with the variable x and t. Now, we know this wave just travels to the right? Now, we need to write an expression for the wave travels in the opposite direction. So you can see at the initial, it travels to the right, then we write an expression right travels to the left. So in this case, amplitude will not change, agree? The angular velocity will not change and the wave number will not change. The only thing changes is direction. So we can replace the t as negative t. So replace t as negative t, the function becomes this one, it works, right? The second one asks you the speed of this wave. So we can see the speed of the wave and then we can see what quantity is given. First one, this part is called amplitude, right? And this one, wave number, k. This part, angular velocity. So we can write the angular velocity as 2 pi over t. So in one circle, it moves, it travels the angle 2 pi over t, right? The wave number, k, is just 2 pi over lambda. In this case, we can write the speed as the wavelength divided by period. It's very easy to understand. In one period, the time taking t and the distance traveled lambda. And then we can write it as lambda divided by 2 pi times 2 pi over t. And this part is called omega. And this part is called k. So it is equal to omega divided by k. And then input omega and k inside, we get the final answer for the speed of the wave. Thank you.